again. I am so glad to be here. And as you can see, I am holding up a book by one of the people that I know and who is also a saxophonist. Remember, I had him on my program some time ago, but this is also a book that he has written. You need to get this book. It is called Grace Psalms, In Psalms of Grace, and it is by Joseph Phillips, Jr. Can I tell you something about this man? When I say that he is definitely a man of God, God has truly gifted him and blessed him. Believe me, this is true. He does a lot of work on the natural realm, but at the same time, it does not stop him from doing the work that God has gifted him and placed in his area to do by whomever he meets. Whenever he meet him, he's always talking about the goodness of the Lord. Now today, not only am I talking about the book that he's written, but he's also here to share some poems that he has written. And with him doing that, it has reminded me of some poems that I have written and have had published in different books in years past, and haven't done a thing with them. But one of the songs that God gave me is, what have you done with what I've given you? He Amen. Wants to know, what have we done with what he gave us? He told us to go in the highways and the byways and to bring his message, but we stick to the four walls. When we come to church, that's all we know. We share it with each other, and then we're done. That is not what he intended. And that is not what I'm about these days. I'm about sharing his word, his blessings, his goodness all over the place. And this man, Joseph Phillips Jr., does the same thing. And here he is, right here in the flesh.
Bless God.
Joseph Phillips Jr., tell us a little bit about how you got started with writing the poems. Well, I know you wrote the book, but yes. What about the poems?
Well, see, those poems are a blessing of anointing that just overflows and come over you.
Uh-huh.
And say, for example, there you are at a time that you most thought you can go and just lay down and have some rest.
Uh-huh.
At this time, while you thought you was resting, you couldn't rest because these overflowing of words were just compositions and just word by word, just dribbling up on you inside,
okay,
just to write. And when you write it, when I have written these words, I was released and I can sleep.
All right.
Sleep.
Well, why don't you share one of the poems with us?
Yes.
The one that I see here is called God's Heart is Near.
You are correct.
Yes.
God's heart is near.
I'd say, well, go ahead and share that one with us.
Yes, God's heart is near. There's a place where souls are healed and souls are spirits, and spirits are summoned, where souls are saved in the kingdom of God. There's a place of glorification and justification, of love and holy faith, in the kingdom of God. There is a place of sanctification and love of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Bishop of our soul, by God our Holy Father, whom sealed in His Holy Spirit in heavenly places in Jesus Christ, for His gift of salvation, anointed after His Holy Spirit. This place is where your heart remains in God's glory by His honor, joy, and mercy and grace after God's own heart. Amen.
Well, all right. See, and when I say poetry, If you know anything about poetry, you know that there is such a thing as prose and poetry. Poetry means it rhymes every other line or every fourth line. This, on the other hand, is prose because it's not about rhyming and making it sound good because everything ends in the same sound. This is about meaning. God's heart yes. is near. This is really a touching poem.
Yes.
And it is on the prose side of all poetry, right. Well, not your poet side of
thank
poetry.
Thank you so much for educating me about poems.
This is nice.
P-O-E-M, it says something.
Yes.
And how powers come together, and by the power of the Holy Ghost that speaks to you and counsel you and carry you and direct you.
Mm-hmm.
This poem here tells the soul through the Spirit that God is present in our life. Uh-huh. And when God is present, and you know He's present, you are secure, you are safe, and you are sound and stable. Knowing that God's presence is there, no other weapon, no other enemy can come against you.
I got you.
Because you are protected with the armor of God.
Mm-hmm.
Because God is love, and that's the total armor of God, His love.
Right.
And this poem touched the heart, as you say, because when we are experiencing some things of such traumatic things in our life, such as death in a family,
mm-hmm.
for example,
mm-hmm.
that is a big thing, death. But you know, death cannot separate us from the love of God. And because we are in emotion, we think about love and about God in an emotional way.
Mm-hmm.
But when you said there's meaning, there is meaning because there is spiritual significance
mm-hmm.
in the quality of who God is in His love.
Mm-hmm.
And because He is love, according to our 1 John 4, and it speaks of that in 1 John 4:16. And so we find that our heart needs to be comforted. And He sent the Holy Ghost to comfort our
heart. Yes.
And when my mother suddenly left to be with the Lord, that was a big blow for me. And these words came to me. And these words was my comfort. These words were directed and anointed that lift me up as my hands lifted up and my eyes looked upon God. Meaning that I know they may say, well, no one can see God. But, you know, we walk by faith.
Mm-hmm.
And having the faith of God in our heart is a perception that is greater than our physical sight.
You got
when we proceed from faith,
you got
we are able to see a thing greater. So that's something about that poem.
Well, good, good. Now, you got another one to share with us?
Yes.
All right.
Yes, we do. And this one is
Now, before you do that,
yes.
I want to let our viewers know that poem, God's Heart is Near,
yes.
is also found in His book, which is called Grace Psalms. And when I say Psalms, I'm speaking of Psalms as it is in the Bible. P-S-A-L-M-S. In Psalms of Grace. And it can be found right here in His book.
Yes.
What's the other one you've got for us?
Well, as you know, immediately after that book was composed, suddenly and once again, there I am, and things are coming to me from to my ears. Every window of perception, the Word of God is shown in His creation as we are being recreated every day, as we be recreated in our Lord Jesus Christ, coming from our sinner's life and coming to a life of sanctification. They say to us today that God's love is our first love, and that's what is written this time, His overflowing love, so abundantly. And this is, God is our first love.
All right. Go ahead.
Thank you. God is our first love. My first love, tender grace, when after love begins in God, all is true. Thy God of gods and Lord of lords, all are in the word of love, for love is with God. Who works and ways and wills are manifested in love. Who is the Alpha and Omega of love? The glory of love is holiness in the spirit of the Holy Ghost. For the word of God is the testimony of love. The voice of love speaks faithfully and true. Thy love bears witness in all I am and do in the righteousness of our Lord Jesus Christ, who acquaints ourselves first with the Lord our God of love, who is the first love, who is governed by the law of love. For Jesus Christ is our Lord and Savior, who loves you and I first. Thy love is irresistible grace in the spirit of love. For grace and mercy hold sure and true in the works of love. The glory of God is love, and love is the glory of God. For the kingdom of God rests in the salvation of love. Thy first love is trusted and believed and dear to our hearts. Healing hearts praise and worship God in the grace of love. Love holds the key to righteousness and faithfulness where our first love remains, where the foundational love is established and true by the word of faith. There is your love where your heart remains, for God's love is first, who is our first love. Thank you. Amen.
All right. Now that is beautiful.
Oh, thank you.
Our first love.
Yes.
That is beautiful. Yeah. Really, that it speaks. It really does. There's no question about it. As I said before, I would be bringing to you people of more than one type, one gift, because you don't always hear about everybody. You hear of this one or that one because they are maybe on the radio and you can hear them because everybody's talking about them. You hear them because their music is all over the place, being played by everybody. But not everybody is being publicized the same way. My job here, what I had said I was going to be doing, was to bring about some music that we would know about people that are here in Detroit that God has blessed us to have among us. Now, he does poetry. I have had poetry published in several books because I'm listed in the internationalpoetry.com society. And believe me, it isn't by mistake I've received awards. And this has been years ago, but my family comes from a group of people who express themselves just that way. They sit and write these words out because this was how they felt. This man sits and writes out what God gives him regarding him so that others will know what God is. Some will sing of what God is. He has written a poem and he writes a book about who God is and what God is. Now, I've got one of my poems here.
Amen.
That I can share with you. It's called Home Front Thoughts. Away from my family, being trained for bad times, with instructors to lead, overcoming loneliness and shortcomings, young and older, but making do, trusting the system and forgetting you, not being builded in faith, but when it counts, we know that it is by your mercy and your grace that we make it back home, all in one piece with our right minds, PTSD, COPD, quadriplegic, paralyzed veterans and more, family members who live through with us are going through the circumstances and the same doors, and keeping us together as best they can. In the governmental status that we're in, we pray for each other and for our legal system. According to your word, Lord, the earth is yours, the world and all that dwell therein. You are in total control, and nothing is for naught. These are my home front thoughts. These are just thoughts I've had simply because I come from a family of military people, uncles, brothers. Now I even have a grandson that is also military. Now, I must let you know that this is not only what I do, but this is what I am.
Amen.
I am a servant of God's will to exhibit, to make aware of everyone who God is, where He is, and what He can do for them. I was just in Dearborn Fine and Performing Arts on the fourth Friday of last month and had a wonderful time with Rufus and Denise Harris and Jean Watson. This woman is truly a gifted woman, violinist, keyboardist, and singer. And she has a program of her own that is aired in England or Ireland. I think it's Ireland. And she is really somebody you should hear. Maybe I'll be able to get her on my program. She is truly an awesome violinist. Now, Rufus plays almost every kind of guitar there is. He's also a producer. He has a studio. He is a pastor of a church. And he sings. And he does prison fellowship ministry. Not just to see them when they're in prison, but after they come out, he assists in any way he can with helping them to get back into society. This is what the word tells us about. We're not just to talk about the love of God, but we are to share the love of God. And the only way you're going to share it is if you give of yourself and your time. Now, the other thing is, on the fourth Friday, because Rufus Harris has fourth Fridays at Dearborn Fine and Performing Arts Building on Michigan Avenue between Southfield and Greenfield, he has those fourth Fridays every month. This coming month, on fourth Friday, which I think is the 24th, he will have Damon Terrell, which is an awesome guitarist. This young man is lead of a group, and they are wonderful. They can entertain you for a long time, but his music is soothing. It is relaxing. It is God sent.
Amen.
And on this month, fourth Saturday, I will be in Lincoln Park at Blessed Hope Mission Cafe. And there's a man there who is also a guitarist. His name is William Reynolds. And he is also a singer and has produced his own CDs. This man is truly gifted of God. God does not have a skin barrier, a complexion barrier. He doesn't have an economic barrier. God deals with us as we come to Him. Whatever situation you're in, from the lowest to the highest, as long as you can come to God, He will most definitely be in you and with you. And that's all we have to do, is be there for Him. He will do this. Now, I thought I was going to be able to share some of the music today from Brother Joseph Phillips, but he did not bring his CD with him, and he has it on his phone, but getting the phone connected to this box that I've got here is not one of the easiest things to do. But in the meantime, I'm going to see if I can connect just a little bit of, because I gave you, now, Brother Phillips, I don't know if you remember, he did saxophone music with us. And he is a beautiful musician as far as playing saxophone. He can do it. He also played keyboard, and he plays piano. I didn't even find that out until much later. But in the meantime, he's going to come back. I'm going to have him back on the program.
Thank you.
And he is going to do some musical selections for you. So that way, when you're interested in having your programs, you'll have heard him and it'll be fresh in your minds that this is somebody you can get for your programs. Now, the other thing I want to share with you is, I don't know how many of you know this, but there's a new place that's opened, and it's called Just a Bit of Soul, and it's in Radford. It is on Plymouth Road. They have wonderful, tasty food, okay? I'm not being paid to make these commercials, do you understand? These are just jobs that God has given me to spread whom He has given a gift to. Maybe you haven't heard about it before, but they have some tasty foods there. And they are open from 7 in the morning until 3 in the evening. They are on Plymouth Road, 25505 Plymouth Road. The breakfast that they offer is truly tasty. Waffles with strawberries and whipped cream. I'm serious. This is some good food. I don't even know the person that really owns the place. I've never really had personal contact with that person. All I can tell you is this is a place you should be spending your money. Not all the time are you going to be blessed everywhere you go to eat, but this is one place you can count on, okay? Now, until we meet again, and I do hope we meet again, send me your information. I can be reached at evesdawn6@gmail.com. If you want to appear on my program, if you have a gift that God has blessed you with, if you have a talent that you want to share with the rest of Detroit and the world. Because after all, this is not only Detroit Cable 20 or 90. This is internet. This is nationwide and worldwide. Anyone who has cable, a telephone, a tablet, an iPhone, if they've got internet on their computers, they can pull this program up. All they've got to do is go to bgntvgospel.com and then pull up my name and they'll see this program. They can pull up anybody else's program on that same network because Bell Global Network is international and we are here. God is spreading His word, His love all over the world through this network, through the people that are on this network. So we look forward to having you view us again on next month. In the meantime, if you want to see us in person, as I said, visit the Dearborn Fine and Performing Arts Building on Fourth Fridays in Dearborn on Michigan Avenue between Southfield and Greenfield. Visit us in Lincoln Park at Blessed Hope Missions Cafe on Hazel. You can see us. You can be with us. Okay? We look forward to seeing you. And contact me anytime. All right? All right. Look for you again.
My name is Mike Duggan, and I'm watching the Bell Global Network.
Hey, keep it locked. It's your boy, D. Hattie, watching the Bell Global Network. You know how it is.
Hi, I'm Charlie Langton, and you're watching the Bell Global Network.
Hi, this is Martha Reeves, and you're watching Bell Global Network.
Hi, everybody. I'm telling you, everything that happened to me that was good, God did it. I'm Evelyn Turrentine, AG, and you're watching the Bell Global Network.
This is Pastor D. Alexander Bullock of Preachers of Detroit, and you're watching the Bell Global Network.
This is Bishop Edgar Vann of Second Ebenezer Church in Detroit, Michigan, and you're watching the Bell Global Network.
Hi, I'm Bernadette Stannis. You know me best as Thelma from the TV show Good Times, and you are watching Bell Global Network.
What's going on, y'all? It's Mr. Bell. Some know me as Antoine Choirboy Bell. Others know me as Elder Anton Bell. I am co-CEO of Bell Global Network, BGN TV 2090. And I want to invite you right now to get your own broadcast. Calling all ministers, all politicians, all business owners. Get your own broadcast right now, starting at $99. And if you have an idea for a TV show, we can bring your idea to reality. We have packages available that includes production and facilities. Also, we have advertising packages starting at $25. So don't hesitate. Give us a call at 313-355-7877. Once again, that's 313-355-7877 to make an appointment today.
You never ever let me down, and when I'm sinking in sin, you never ever let me drown. You're my lifeguard, my security. You took my insecurities and put me in the lion's den and took out all the fear in me and gave.